Never mind, my head, now there's X and Y in the back.
Bye. You want to get him and give him a hug?
Yeah, group hug.
Group hug.
I don't know.
How do I remember which people have arrived and then they've left?
I don't know, really. Oh, so. Try that group hug. Group hug. Cool. Boy, that quasi guy's almost as ugly as you, Jill.
How dare you?
I'm Yeah. us. Anything for a shot, right?
That's right.
I like that. Ready to move on?
Let's do it.
Andrew, get that shot?
Sure did, boss.
We're moving on, man. Next setup, please.
Yes, sir. Let's strike the temple, folks. We're moving to Cairo in 5 minutes. Whoa, hello, everybody. What do you think so far?
Right. Wide angle lens.
Right.
Yeah, I'm going to dolly camera be left to right to follow the action.
On this crane camera, I want to go ahead and run that at 36 frames a second. Give us a nice slow motion on the high fall.
Sure.
Do that?
Awesome.
Thank you. Tom, how are we doing with the truck?
All set, Steve.
Very good. Well, now, don't you all look great? I want to thank you for helping out today. Now, you do understand that you represent the entire population of Cairo, right?
Right.
Good luck. You gonna stay with him, Kristen?
Through the whole scene, boss.
All right, let's get ready to run it. Can we get it in one take, Candace, Scott? Thank you. As soon as we're ready, Dan, call it, please.
Yes, sir. Places, please. Places, everybody. X is ready. Thank you very much, Kristen. Scott, team, you ready? Thank you, guys. Cameras ready?
All set, Dan.
Roll cameras.
Rolling. Word speed.
Collins fixing 124 Apple. Cairo encounter, take one, Mark.
Playback. Background action.
And action. Real good in slow motion. Candace, you You are perfect. Exactly what I needed. Thank you. On the header here, Paul. Like your header. Next time, hang on to the gun. All right. Truck number one. Camera on the new Mark 8. Dan, let's move the extras back to a safe distance.
Absolutely. Extras, please follow me this way. We,
Okay, great. I am ready back here.
You all set over there, Tom? I'll let you know. Okay, quiet on the set, please. Very quiet. Cameras ready?
All set, Dan.
Roll cameras.
Rolling. Warp speed.
Common stick scene 114 Apple, Cairo chasing. Take one, Mark.
Chuck's up!
Dennis, you sure you're good with this?
Let's do it.
Background action!
Explosives, one of the most hazardous things a stunt player has to deal with. However, something that looks simple as a fight scene can be just as dangerous. It takes time and practice and coordination to make it look like you're actually hitting somebody. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Kristen, can I borrow one of your extras for a little demonstration, please?
Sure, awesome. Actually, I think I have the perfect guy for you. Hey, sir. Help us out?
Dan. Give me somebody who can really throw a punch.
Throw a punch. Yes, sir. Oh, Rich. Right. Perfect. Rich, the director needs you over there to throw a punch.
Thanks for helping us today, Jim. Happy Thanksgiving. That was excellent.
Rich, you might hurt him, okay?
And I get you to go ahead and do the demonstration.
Oh, okay. Yeah, this really is. How you doing, Jim? Come on over here. Just stand right here. I don't want you to move. Yeah, that's good. All right? Okay. Okay. Now, in a fight routine, taking a butt is... Okay. You're going to stay over there, right? Okay. Oh, boy. Like I was trying to say, in a fight routine, taking punch is just as important as throwing one. Sir, are you okay?
Yeah.
I am so sorry. I'm so, see what I mean? You can really get hurt if you don't have the right timing. Sir, try not to lean into it.
Am I bleeding?
You're doing fine. Just roll with the punches. All right. So, you see? It takes guts, pull, coordination, and a real level head. Okay. Well, you know what, boss? I think something like this would take a lot of rehearsal.
Or a lot of extras.
Oh, we got some of those.
Candace, just help him up, please.
Oh, okay. Excuse me, sir. Sir? Sir!
One of our stuntmen, Mr. Jim Shelley.
Action.
Thank you. fearsome here, but I just don't feel it. I think I'm just coming off as annoying.
Don't worry, Rex. You'll get it. We're all rooting for you.
As we leave the loading area, you're towards your right-hand side, the Star's parking lot. Several unique modes of transportation used by our Disney Stars. Large silver space pods in the 86th movie, Flight of the Navigator. It's only one of two space pods used in the movie. It was the one used where the actors had to go in and out of the pod. Working 2 a.m. from the movie set. The sculpted figures are called topiary and can take 3 months up to 10 years to grow, depending upon their size and type. We currently have over 180 topiary here at the Walt Disney World properties. Beige buildings for Hushmas, the first full-length feature filmed here at the studios. Pink Mercedes there in the driveway was used by Dolly Parton in the movie Straight Talk. We have 8 homes along Residential Street. Each has been used in one production or another, some a bit more famous than others. Small Town Church. Wide open windows, simple clapboard sides, blurred and shingles, everything perfect for a church in the small town of Residential Street. After Blackjack Savage Fever from the 100 Lives of Blackjack Savage, starring Stoney Jackson. Several military vehicles, some of which were used by Steven Spielberg in Indiana Jones and The Last Crusade. And as the metal tread in the tank is not made of metal, but made of foam rubber, to make it easier on our stuntmen when they had to be drug across it. Coming up further ahead, 3 of 7 blue plumbers from Who Framed Roger Rabbit, each representing a different stage of destruction in the same vehicle. We did that because the movie was not filmed in sequence. Polycarp, also from Who Framed Roger Rabbit, is just a modified city bus. The steel wheels are fiberglass coverings placed over the bus's radial tires. Coming up, we have a blue helicopter cockpit from the movie Blue Thunder. 2 aircraft from the movie The Rocketeer, starring Bill Campbell, Jennifer Connelly, and Timothy Dalton. 2 push carts and a bobsled from 93 film Coral Runnings, 2 futuristic looking vehicles from Blade Runner, 1 red Coyote car from Hardcastle McCormick, 2 boxes from the USS Alabama in the movie Crimson Tide. Take a look across the canal, you get a backstage view of those homes on Residential Street. No insides or backs to any of them. Around here, we only build what the camera needs to shoot. Production is pretty small, saving money. Around here, we save all we can, and we saved up enough that we can buy ourselves a canyon. Directly in front of us. Looks like Michelle has his clearance to go on inside. Have to warn you though, the bridge we're staying on is very bumpy. Please keep a firm grip on any loose sidings you're carrying. Purses, cameras, California took up their team almost 6 months to build it. From my time for 1 step, and I'm mad considering how long it takes Mother Nature. The oil drilling equipment is authentic, all taken from oil fields out in southern Texas, no longer in production. The tanker truck is a good example of one that might be in the boneyard. Doesn't look great, but it runs well. However, since they couldn't drive it in here over the ravine, they had to hoist it by crane over the walls of the canyon and down into position for the shot where you see it now. Probably can't see them. Our high-powered rain sprinklers, we have mounted on the end of those sprinklers, which can spray high-pressure water out in a crisscross pattern and make it look somewhat like actual rain. That is a good way to cue up that rain effect. Anybody up there? There, okay. They probably just had trouble here. You'll notice the rain doesn't go to the back of the tank. In fact, the tank is tucked in and it gets wet. This goes far enough back to pull the cameras. I can think it goes all the way. We'd love to show you some of the other sequences out here, but I'm afraid we cannot run them with a score group of guests inside here. Things like scene one, for instance. Scene one, take two. Looks like we're going to be caught here for just a couple of seconds. Hold on tight, try to stand. We'll get you out of here as soon as possible.
Thank you.
reset for another take? I think not. I think one take, that's about all I can take, Michelle. You're all clear to take the out of here. Folks, that's why it's called Catastrophe Canyon. We're going to take around back to the house and the catastrophe we're really created. We're clear. The fire's explosions you saw. Long larger white pipes carried the water from the flash flood. Triggered by opening gates, the three holding tanks on top of the canyon, sending 70,000 gallons of water rushing down the canyon walls towards our tour tram. So the water bone and ashes used the green air cannons. Each one of the air cannons caused a basketball over the top of the Empire State Building. The earthquake effect you felt created by hydraulic shaker tables underneath the bridge we were traveling on. Each one of the shaker tables able to toss a one-ton vehicle over the railing and into the base of the canyon. Catastrophe Canyon was created with the help of a Hollywood special effects team. What seemed to you and I like an out-of-control disaster actually was.
Tommy. As I'm going in line here, so if they come out, if you tell me just come out. Don't get soaked.
Good.
Ferry. Heli. Joanne, group hug.
No.
Group hug.
No.
Group hug.
No.
Phil.
That we're gonna do here. Mom!